Hello, hope you're fine where you are, and well kept, preserved, and keeping well in the Lord. I'm Bonke Okumu. I love Jesus as Lord and Savior of my life, and I count it a privilege to be a child of God. I count it a blessing to be a disciple of Jesus, being taught, being a student of Jesus each and every minute of my life. I bless the name of the Lord for this far and for this opportune time He has given us and enable us to share and feast together. Before we even step forth to the subject of our discussion, let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you, Lord, for the gift of life, the gift of one another. Thank you for the gift of the saving faith, the gift of your word, and your love, O God, upon our lives. Thank you, Lord, for the gift of one another. Even as we feast together, Lord, we anchor our hope and trust in you, Jesus. The Lord, even as we interact about, as we share and feast about the concept of intimacy with you, Jesus, Lord, we pray that, Lord, as you reveal yourself unto us, Lord, even as you make manifest, O Lord, yourself, O God, and your statutes, Lord, in our lives, my Father, let the yearning and the desire and the passion, Lord, to draw closer to you be more and more in us, O God. May we be continually spurred up and stirred up by your Spirit, Lord, to desire to draw closer to you. We thank you and we bless your name. In Jesus' name. Amen. I thank God for today, in this particular moment. The subject of our sharing is intimacy with Jesus. And intimacy with Jesus is a very basic concept, a very basic or a very necessary subject in the life of a disciple of Jesus, in the life of child of God. Anyone who identifies with the saving faith in Christ Jesus, your relationship with Jesus or your intimate relationship with Jesus is a core concern in your life and in my life. And I bless the name of the Lord that even as we go forth to gist on this subject, let our hearts be open, let our minds be open, and be ready, trusting that God Himself will reveal to us at personal level what it calls for or what it means to us, or how or to what extent do we value our relationship with Him. Hope you're fine and ready to learn one or two things about this subject. Intimacy with Jesus calls for a relationship with Him, and relationship with Jesus begins when someone confesses Him as Lord, when someone confesses Him as Lord and Savior over his or her life. And confession is not complete unless the revelation of who Jesus is becomes clear to somebody. Not by the words, just words of your mouth, not just by any kind of belief, but a belief in your heart and confession by your word of mouth that Jesus is the Son of God, that Jesus is the Lord, and Savior over your life. It is anchored on that revelation, not just as something pronounced, but a revelation that I've captured somebody, that I've captured one's life, which enables one or gives somebody ability to confess that Jesus is Lord over his life. So our intimate relationship with Jesus begins with us relating with him as a Messiah and as Lord of our lives. The journey begins when we human beings realize and know our identity in Christ Jesus. Through Christ Jesus. And our relationship started in Christ Jesus and with Jesus himself ought to grow, ought to be perfected from level to level. And as you continually become a student or a disciple or a child of God who is really yearning, who is having that daily pursuit of drawing closer to Jesus, the know-how of what Jesus expects of me, of you and me, the know-how of who he is and how his identity is inscribed in us is very key for you and me, even in understanding what he expects of us. Intimacy with Jesus is a call for daily death to self and Christ living in you. It's a call to daily submission to the authority, to the lordship of Christ Jesus. It's a call to the desire, daily yearning to know that which God expects of you. It's a daily desire to be found in the will of God. So our relationship with Jesus, as we grow intimately, as we grow in intimate relationship with Jesus, we have to understand or get to know our identity when we get born again, the will of God for us, and the ultimate goal of our relationship with Jesus. When the ultimate goal of your relationship with your Savior is clearly known to you, then growing into closeness with your Savior, growing into openness and that intent relationship with your Savior won't be something to rethink about, but you will have that yearning, you'll have that desire, you'll have that willingness, and count it a responsibility at personal level to cultivate your daily walk in the race of faith and your closeness with Jesus. And that is the subject of our talk at this particular time. So the ultimate goal of our relationship with Jesus is us becoming like him, until we come to the full measure of his stature, until we come to full conformity with the image of Christ until we attain to maturity, until we attain to the fullness of His stature. So in our daily pursuit, in our walk with the Lord, the goal has to be clear for us. The goal has to make sense for us at individual level. So growing intimately with Jesus is a call for relationship with Him, knowing what He expects of you and me, knowing what privileges and provisions He has given us to enable us intimately relate with Him, to enable us intimately do that which He shows us forth, that which He directs us, that which is His counsel for us, that which is His wisdom, that which is His mind, that He is desiring to be established in our lives. As to a relationship between man and man, a human being and another human being, the either parties do expect to understand, to know that which they expect of each other. So the same way in our walk with the Lord, in our walk in the saving faith in Christ Jesus, that which He is expecting of us is very crucial in our lives and in our undertakings, in our daily lives. While we cultivate our salvation or the walk of faith, Jesus becomes the central figure. Jesus becomes the basic. Jesus becomes the core. So, relating with Jesus, or the intimate relationship with Jesus, defines the nature or the state of our identity, the state of His image inscribed in us. I say the level of your conformity to who Christ is the level of your maturity in the walk of faith. The level of your maturity is determined by the level of Christ-likeness in you. And as human beings, we have no ability to measure to what extent am I Christ-like. And it is not me trying to make Christ who I should be, but it's about Christ making me who I should be. So as I said earlier, it's a call of dying to self and Christ living in us. As Paul will tell you in Galatians 2:20, that it's I have been crucified with Him, and it's no longer I who lives, but Christ who lives in me. So it's a call to daily die to self and Christ living in you. And in the scripture we have some of the lines I would want us to interact with. In Colossians 3:10, Paul tells the church that we who are in newness of nature in Christ Jesus, we are meant to grow or to conform to the image of Christ through His knowledge. So the intent or of our relationship, or the ultimate goal of our relationship, is full stature of Christ, the fullness of Christ being inscribed in us, us becoming Christ-like. And we have a daily call of dying to self and Christ living in us. So each and every time we are conformed to the image of Christ through his knowledge. And that's one of the provisions, the word of God, the knowledge of Christ Jesus. Through the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ, we are able to be stirred up, to be able to be conformed to his likeness. And by which mechanism does this word become life in us? Does this word become practical in us and enable us to walk as Christ would? Because when we talk of intimate relationship with Jesus, it means doing that which he does, doing that which he tells us to do, being like him in every aspect, being like him in every core of our life, in every sphere of our life. We tend to portray the image of Jesus Christ. It's not something you are trying to do. It's something that you can actually be enabled by him to do. It's not about you trying to do like him, but him enabling you to do. So the Spirit of God, who is a life-giving spirit, the very word of God is his sword. He inspires the word of God into life in us. So we daily conform to the image of Christ through his knowledge by his Spirit inspiring the very word into life in us. That very word being inspired into life, able to live in us, able to govern us. And we get to practicality of the word itself by the help of the Spirit of God. So our daily pursuit of drawing closer to Jesus is through his knowledge. So as you draw closer to him, it is very basic for you to have the knowledge of him on a daily basis. And I'll say a simple application that can help a believer or a disciple to conform to Christ-likeness is being a student of the knowledge of Christ, being a student of the knowledge of Christ, yearning to hear from him. Like when your will is controlled by the will of Christ, when your mind is controlled by the mind of Christ, that mind that was in him controlling your mind, through his knowledge renewing your mind every time, you are able to be conformed to him. You are able to be changed or being transformed to the likeness of that very word. So that word becoming a practical thing in your life conforms you to the image of Christ, because the knowledge of Christ is who he is. The knowledge of Christ is the carrier of the ability and the power to enable a mortal human being like you and me to conform to the image of Christ. So our daily relationship with Jesus, or every time relationship with Jesus, is based on the access we have to his knowledge. It's not about that knowledge just remaining a knowledge in us, but that knowledge being inspired into life in us, that we no longer act to prove that which is in us, but that which is in us acts, empowers us, stirs us up. So our basic role is receiving with meekness that which God has availed as an ability to work in us, and that is the knowledge of Christ Jesus, that His Spirit inspires into life in our lives. So it's a call for you and for me to be students of the knowledge of Christ. If your aim is to intimately grow in your relationship with Jesus, to grow intimately, to grow or to mature in the nature of Christ, to conform to the image of Christ, then the knowledge of Christ is a necessity. The knowledge of Him who found you, the knowledge of Him who found the new nature in you is very basic. So our daily pursuit should be anchored on the truth of the Lord, the Word, the Sword of the Spirit of God, that is able to change us, that is able to transform us, because the ultimate goal of an intimate relationship with Jesus is becoming like Him. So one of the provisions that we have is the Word of God, and every other thing revolves around the knowledge of Christ. When you are told to put on the full armor of God, I've seen everything is around, or everything is revolving around the belt of truth, is hanging around the belt of truth, which is the knowledge of Christ. If it is your faith in Him, you are perfected in the faith, you are perfected in believing and trusting and relying on God through the knowledge of Christ. If it is the ability and the enablement to be a witness to Him, it is through His knowledge. So by the help of the Spirit of God, through the knowledge of Christ Jesus, we are able to be chastened, to attain intimacy with Jesus. Through His knowledge, you'll know what He expects of you. Through His knowledge, you'll receive that ability when His Spirit inspires that very knowledge into life in you and me. You will be able to know, will be able to understand, will be able to be to get that empowerment, to receive, to find that grace, to obtain that ability that God avails for you and me as His children, to be able to walk, talk, and do our things like Him. So our intimate relationship with Jesus also governs, have an influence in our daily conduct, in our speech, in our actions, and in all things we do. How we relate with other people is should be impacted by our relationship with Jesus. So at the same time, it's a call for separation for the sake of guarding your identity in Him. Let it be your daily desire, let it be your daily pursuit of having an access of the knowledge of Him who found you. So be a student of the knowledge of Christ Jesus. So by His blood He cleansed us from sin. By His word He is consecrating us each and every time we get that knowledge. And through the help of His Spirit, He is inspiring us. He's inspiring His word into life in us, to empower us, to enable us to walk like Him, talk like Him, do our things like Him. And getting conformed to his likeness. Amen. So he says, my sheep knoweth my voice and hears when I call. In Revelation 3:20, though this is a letter to the church, I view this verse as something to an individual, a disciple of Jesus, a child of God. This should be clear to you. Revelation 3:20 says, Jesus says to this church in Laodicea, or the church at Laodicea, behold, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice, not the knock, if anyone hears my voice and open the door, I will come in and sup with him. I'll come into him and sup with him, and him with me. So, as a child of God, or as a disciple of Jesus, getting intent into your relationship with Jesus, such that you grow intimately, you grow in intimacy with him, such that you are able to hear him, you are able to hear that which he's telling you, you are able to perceive his voice, you are able to clearly get and understand that which he commands you to do, that which he directs you to do. An analogy that really interests me so much is when a child and his parent or guardian grows intimately in their relation at home, it comes a point where when the parent just knocks at the door, the child is able to perceive, even just by hearing the knock, is able to perceive the voice and the owner of the voice, and is able to know the person knocking at the door, even without a confirmation, even without opening the door. So, getting to an extent where you're able to hear him, where you're able, his directions are so clear to you, his directions and his commands are so clear to you, that you get into depth with him, that at the knock he makes at the door of your heart, you are able to get the intent or the gist of what Jesus is directing you to do. So to walk like him, to talk like him, to do all things that we do like him, to be able to behold the mind of Christ, to be able to behold the will of God in our daily pursuit, in our relationship with him, we grow intimately in our relationship with Jesus based on the access or our responsiveness to the knowledge of Christ. And as Paul would say, that we are meant to grow into the image of him who found us through his knowledge. So the knowledge of Christ is a basic, is a necessity for you and me as a child of God, as a disciple of Jesus, as a student of the knowledge of Christ, to enable you to be spurred, to be stirred up by his Spirit, to conform to his image. Intimacy with Jesus is a call to daily dying to self and Christ living in you. It's a call to daily heeding and abiding in the knowledge of Christ. Unless you abide in him, unless you remain in him, you can't grow intimately with him. So consistency is key in your relationship with Jesus. So be daily yearning to be a student of the knowledge of Christ. God bless you.